Yes, sir. I can see that. Go ahead, tell us. Yes, sir. What is easier to, what makes it easier to get a woman?
Nowadays, the women were so abundant.
Yeah.
In a way that people don't even hustle before they get a woman.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Our forefathers, they have to send it to your hometown.
Yes.
Send it to a special family.
Mm-hmm.
So the fatigue you do before you
get settled, yes.
You like to put it away.
That is true. Thank you, sir. Good point. Good one there. All right. I think that's a good one. Well, I think we run out of time now. So, Wema, give us your closing word on this. I think we got to get back to this very topic and you know, do justice to it.
Okay.
Yes.
My final word to all listeners is that, let's use godly wisdom to enter into our marriages.
But I want you to say along these lines, in answer to the question we asked, we posed from the very beginning, can a divorced Christian remarry?
According to what Jesus said, it is no.
Hello, good morning. Hey, Aroma, how are you? I've been thinking of you lately. How are you? How is your husband? What did he say? I'm sure she didn't get it or she missed it. She's been very, very busy lately, but you can do that later. But give us your question quickly or your remark. Counseling, huh?
Yeah, so it's that one. Because if the problem comes, it goes back to you, the pastor, again.
Mm-hmm.
So I think during the counseling, the pastor don't have time to pray with the people. It's not that there, so because sometimes they come and they don't say that to them, they say, oh, yeah, we have prayed, but maybe they don't have time really to pray, you know, to seek the face of God. So if they come to you and you will have time to pray with them, I think I don't understand.
God bless you.
Thank you very much.
God bless you so much, Auntie Rama. What I want to come out with is that when you are doing the counseling, like 3 months, 6 months, some of them will tell you it is too long.
Some and of them are even pregnant.
If you insist, they will run the church. They will run out of the church and go to another church.
And many people who are also there, who are their supporters, will support them and leave. So when they come in, man of God, they are even the one that determines, please, we just want it for 2 weeks.
Yes.
So even if you are telling them, no, you need to know this guy, and you begin to ask them some serious questions about each other, they dodge from it, and then they begin to deviate. They don't come to church anymore, and they run away, and they go to another church, and the pastor there waits them.
That is the problem, you see. So the couples that will come for counseling do not relate to the counselor.
No. At all.
They don't. At all.
Their own agenda.
Yes.
And they have their own agenda.
Yeah.
And they will come with their proposal.
Mm-hmm.
People, and if you don't want to go by their proposal, they run out of you.
People came to us. Excuse me, just to add up this, man of God. People came to us and then we began to see that this guy cannot really marry this girl.
Mm.
We began to find out. We said, academically, you can't marry this girl because the difference is too much.
Mm.
Or social-wise, you can't say marry this girl because the nature of her work have exposed her to serious people.
Mm.
And then background-wise, you can't marry this girl because there's a way your family is and there's a way her family is.
Mm-hmm.
While we are bringing out all of this, we said, how are you going to marry her? So because you don't have any job.
Mm.
How are you going to marry her? Because we don't want to talk about the undocumentation here. Because if we talk about that one day, we'll say, because somebody's illegal, then you don't want her to marry somebody God have brought into her life. But you can't marry this guy because academically, both of you cannot really measure up. Socially, you both of you cannot measure up.
Mm.
So you know what? They began to think that we didn't want them. And then the next thing was that even when they entered into the relationship, just 2 weeks, the man had hitted the girl, beat the girl, the whole face was so swollen up.
Mm.
You know, so swollen up. And then the next thing we see is that just drifted the girl out from the ministry because when they come in, you see that the face is so swollen.
Mm.
You see that somebody's sitting on top of a woman who is pregnant.
Mm.
And then you want to say, no, this is domestic violence. It cannot continue. Mm. Before you know it, bam, they just moved away. And then they have their alibis who are supporting them already, who feel that it must be this way or it must be that way. So a pastor really do not have much to really influence the life of two people who have made up their mind that they want to marry.
Mm.
That is what I have seen.
Yeah, we are even having these problems in our families. If a young girl from a father and a mother want to see a boy and want to marry, and the father sees that this guy wouldn't fit you, like you are saying, he is not responsible.
Yeah.
He doesn't have a home.
Yeah.
He doesn't have a job. He's like that. So if the father says, Papa, you don't want me to get my lover.
Yeah.
You don't want me
she
to
goes
marry.
And carry pregnancy.
You see them.
Yes.
You see your daughter run out of the house.
Exactly.
That she goes away.
Mm-hmm.
You see. So
saw,
if it comes like
I
that,
father,
it is not the, problem
saw,
or the fault
saw,
of the parent.
I saw a father hit the daughter with some stick. I couldn't believe it. I'll never forget that.
Uh-huh.
Because the girl was messing around with other men. And the father wanted the best for the girl.
Mm.
But the girl was running loose. That's the man. Well, these are some of the issues why, you know, marriages don't stay. But we want to trust God that He will help us to have good marriages. And for you who is out there, either if you've been divorced and you're looking to remarry, there are possibilities. And don't get discouraged. We believe that there's hope for you. And